In this tutorial, I will show you how to use the calendar in Monday, how to customize it according to your needs, and demonstrate two ways to implement the calendar in Monday. The first approach involves adding the calendar view to a specific board, which will then display data only from that board. The second approach involves adding a calendar widget to the dashboard, which will allow us to pull data from multiple boards and display it in one place. Before we begin, I want to mention one thing, which is that the calendar view in Monday is only available on the standard plan and above. So depending on the pricing plan you are using, you may or may not have access to the calendar view on your account. Boards and items we will work with. So let's start with the board based on which we'll create a calendar. Here we have the board with items. The board is divided into groups based on the priority of each item. For each item, we also have some basic data such as the people assigned to the item, the item status, duration, deadline, price, and the country column. Some items on the board also have sub-items. In this case, the most relevant columns for us will be those containing deadlines and durations, as these are the data Monday will use to appropriately arrange items in the calendar. How to use the calendar. Now let's see how the calendar in Monday works in practice. To add a calendar view to the board, click on this icon here. Go to More Views and select Calendar. Now we have our calendar, which has fetched items from our board and arranged them based on the date specified. To see which columns the calendar takes into account, go to Settings, and in the tab, choose which columns data to view in this calendar. You'll find a list of columns from which the calendar can pull date information. Right now, we have the deadline columns checked, so the calendar displays specific items for a particular date. If we also check the duration column, the calendar will also show the duration of each item. For example, for task 4, we now see both the deadline and the duration of the item. When using the calendar, you can click on an item to display an item card, which shows information about that item. Here we can modify this information, and any changes made will also be reflected in our table view. Similarly, any changes made using the table view will also be updated in the calendar. You can also move items around on the calendar, which will change their date. For example, if I move this task 1 to a different date, you can see that the date is also updated in the table view. Here you have the option to navigate through the calendar. You can navigate through upcoming and previous months by clicking the Today button. You will return to the current date in the calendar. Here you can change the view of your calendar. Currently, it's set to a monthly view, but you can also switch to a weekly or daily view. If you set the view to a weekly or daily view, you will also have hours displayed. If you did not select a specific hour when setting the date, your item would be displayed here. However, if an item has a specified hour, it will be displayed next to the corresponding hour. If we have so many items assigned to a given day that we can't see them all, we can click here and the full list of items will be displayed. By default, items will be displayed in order according to the set hours. If a time has not been set for some items, they will simply be displayed at the top of the list, in the same order as on the board view. From the calendar, you can also add items to your board. For example, if you want to add an item with a deadline set for, let's say December 12th, I can hover over this date, click on it, and an item card will appear where I can input specific item information. If I click on the date, for example, December 12th, when adding an item, the date of this item will automatically be filled in as December 12th. Notice that the group to which an item should be added will automatically be set to the first group on our board. Of course, we can choose a different group here. Once you've entered all the information for the new item, click Create Item, and the new item will be added to the board and consequently displayed on the calendar. Calendar settings. Now that we understand how to use the calendar, let's move on to settings to see how we can customize it. Under the Choose Which Columns Data to View in this Calendar tab, you have a list of columns from which the calendar can pull date information. We currently have the deadline column selected, so the calendar displays specific items for a particular date. But if we also select the duration column, the calendar will also show the duration of the given item. We also have the option to select sub-item columns. If I add a date column to my sub-items, I can also include data from this column in the calendar and see sub-items in the calendar. Next, in the Color By tab, we can choose what should determine the color of items in the calendar. For example, if we choose the country column, items will be colored according to the country selected in that column. If we choose group, items will be colored according to the group they belong to. We can also choose how sub-items are colored. Moving on to more settings, we have an option regarding the display of hours, specifically whether hours should affect how items are arranged on the calendar. If we uncheck this option, items will be arranged in the same order as on the table view, without considering the specific time the item is set for. We also have an option to hide or show the color legend, which shows what each item color represents. There is also an option to choose default event duration. When you use the daily or weekly view of the calendar and select a default event duration of, for example, 120 minutes, the sizes of the items on the calendar will be adjusted to that time. This makes it clear to view what time is reserved for each item. Then, in the Choose Groups tab, we can select which group's content is displayed in the calendar. There are a few more options related to our calendar that might be useful. For example, we can search for data in the calendar. We can filter the calendar by a specific person, meaning that only items and sub-items related to this person will be included in the calendar. And then we can save this filter, so that the calendar will be displayed this way every time. By the way, after we filter the calendar by a given person, an item or sub-item that is not assigned to this person may still be displayed, because it's related to a sub-item or item that is assigned to that person. We can also choose our filter using the quick or advanced filter options, so the calendar will be displayed in a specific way, and then we also have the option to save this filter. Another option is undock this widget, which allows you to adjust the size of your calendar, move it around, and add other widgets. If the calendar is the only widget here, clicking dock can revert it back to the previous view. If you add more widgets, you won't be able to use the dock this widget option. I'm showing you this dock undock option because it can be useful if you want to have multiple calendars in one place. For example, I can have one calendar that only shows deadlines and another that only displays item durations. If we use these filters right here, we will apply them to both calendars. If we open a given calendar, we can apply filters specifically to that calendar. Now, if we go to the full view of a given calendar and search for something in the calendar, we can save what we searched for so that only the search data will be displayed on the calendar later. Another option we have after we undock our calendar is to use split mode. When we enter full view, we can change the display type to split mode. So in addition to the calendar itself, the board that is the data source for the calendar will be displayed. Calendar in the dashboard. So the calendar we've been working with so far was a view on this board. So the only data source for this calendar was this board. However, in Monday, we can also create a calendar that will pull data from multiple boards. Now, in addition to this board from which we've pulled data to the calendar so far, we'll also pull data from this board called Tasks Team B. Both boards have the same groups and column structure, but there are different items added to them. To create a calendar that will pull data from multiple boards, we will add a calendar as a widget in the dashboard. To create a dashboard, click on the plus sign and click on New Dashboard. Let's name our dashboard Dashboard Calendar. We can choose whether it should be visible to everyone in your account or private, accessible only to you and selected team members. Then click Create Dashboard. The first thing that will appear is the option Connect Boards to this Dashboard. Here we can choose from which boards our dashboard will pull data. In this case, I will choose the Tasks Team A board and Tasks Team B board. Next, click Done. By clicking on Connected Boards, we can see which boards have been added as a data source, add additional boards, or remove boards that we've added to the dashboard. Now click Add Widget and More Widgets. Then choose Calendar. A calendar widget will appear. What's new in the calendar settings is the Boards tab, which has a list of boards from which the calendar can pull data. We see here two boards that we added to our dashboard. But we can also add more boards. Then we can select from which boards the calendar should pull data. Let's choose both boards. Now we have the same options as before, but for multiple boards. We can select columns from both boards, choose what should determine the color of items from both boards, and select which groups from which boards are displayed in the calendar. Now when we use split mode, the calendar itself and the two boards that we have selected as its data sources will be displayed. Just like before, we can use the calendar as usual. We can navigate through the calendar, change the view of your calendar. Items are displayed, we can move them and change their data. However, when adding a new item to the calendar, we will have an additional option, which is to choose to which of the boards the item should be added. We also have filtering options. In our dashboard, we can also add other widgets, such as additional calendars, and customize each of them to meet our requirements. To do this, we first need to click Undock this widget. We can then adjust our existing calendar and, for example, add another one. To modify the calendar settings, click on the three-dot icon and select Settings. If we only have one widget on our dashboard, as in this case, where we have a single calendar, we can use the Dock This Widget option, which will again display the calendar across the entire dashboard. Okay, before we finish, I've got one more thing for you. If you are a new user of Monday and not yet fully familiar with all its features and the platform as a whole, I encourage you to watch our Monday Beginner's Guide. It's a free video guide in which we will go through the essential elements and features of Monday.com. It will give you a general idea of what you can do with Monday and how to set up and use your Monday account. So if you want to quickly familiarize yourself with Monday.com, this is the guide for you. To get our Monday Beginner's Guide, click on the link in the description of this video, and it will direct you to our website where you can access the guide for free.